Google penalties are very similar to sports penalties. At their core, they're designed to punish websites that have done something wrong. And in a nutshell, you can say that these Google penalties are punishments or negative impacts that hurt a website's Google ranking or even remove them from search engine entirely. If Google suspects that a website has violated its policies and uses black hat SEO tactics, it may issue a penalty against that website. And the way Google does this is by handing out penalties both manually as well as algorithmically. With that being said, knowing the type of penalty that Google hit you with and why you have been penalized are the first steps to recovery. In this video, we'll cover most common Google SEO penalties and how to recover from them, starting with manual actions. Now, these are the SEO penalties that are manually applied by a human reviewer at Google and include, number one, thin content. It refers to pages with little or no original content or pages that are too short and provide little value to the user. To fix this penalty, you need to add high quality and unique content to your pages, ensuring that each page provides value to the user. Number two, unnatural links. It refers to links that violate Google's webmaster guidelines, such as paid links or links from link schemes. To fix this penalty, you need to identify the unnatural links and remove them or disavow them using Search Console. You should also make sure to follow Google's guidelines when building any new backlink to your site. Number 3. User-generated spam. Now, user-generated spam refers to content submitted by users that is spammy, such as comments or forum posts with link to low quality or irrelevant content. To fix this penalty, you need to identify and remove the spammy content and implement measures to prevent user-generated spam in future, such as using moderation tools or setting up captcha on your site. Number 4. Hacked content. Now, hacked content refers to pages that have been hacked and contain spammy or malicious content. To fix this penalty, you need to identify and remove the hacked content and take steps to secure your website to prevent future hacks, such as updating your website software or using strong passwords. Number 5. Pure spam. Now, pure spam refers to sites that use spammy tactics to manipulate search rankings, such as cloaking, keyword stuffing, or scraping content from other sites. To fix this penalty, you need to identify and remove the spammy content and make sure to follow Google's guidelines when optimizing your site. Next, number 6, hidden text and keyword stuffing. Now, hidden text and keyword stuffing refers to tactics that involve stuffing keywords into your page's content or hiding text from users to manipulate search rankings. To fix this penalty, you need to identify and remove the hidden text or keyword stuffing and make sure to follow Google's guidelines when optimizing your site. Next, number 7, cloaking and sneaky redirects. It refers to tactics that involve showing different content to users and search engines or redirecting users to a different page than the one they clicked on. To fix this penalty, you need to identify and remove the cloaking or sneaky redirects from your site and make sure to follow Google's guidelines when optimizing your site. Next, number 8, spammy structured markup. Now, spammy structured markup refers to the use of structured data markup in a way that violates Google's guidelines, such as marking up content that is hidden or irrelevant to the page. To fix this penalty, you need to identify and remove the spammy structured markup and make sure to follow Google's guidelines when implementing structured data on your site. Lastly, do note, in manual actions, to fix any penalty, you need to address the specific issues that caused that penalty and make sure to follow Google's guidelines when optimizing your site. Once you've fixed the issue, you can submit a reconsideration request to Google explaining the steps you've taken to address the issue and prevent it from happening in the future. Further, the second category of Google penalty includes the ones based on algorithmic changes and happens automatically without any manual intervention from Google. It includes the following. Number 1. Panda penalty. It targets low-quality content, including thin content, duplicate content, and content that's stuffed with keywords. And to fix this penalty, you need to focus on creating high-quality, original content that provides value to the users. So, if you're facing this penalty, you should remove any duplicate content, thin content or keyword stuffed content from your site. Number 2, Penguin Penalty. Now, it targets sites with low quality backlinks or spammy link profiles. To fix this penalty, you need to identify any low quality or spammy backlinks pointing to your site and remove and disavow them. You should also focus on building high quality, relevant backlinks to your site. Next, number 3, Hummingbird Penalty. It focuses on semantic search and natural language processing. And in order to avoid a hummingbird penalty, you need to focus on creating content that's relevant to your users' search queries and that answers their questions in a natural way in your target content. Next, number 4, Mobile Penalty. Now, this algorithm targets sites that aren't mobile friendly. To fix this penalty, you need to make sure that your site is mobile friendly by using a responsive design or a separate mobile site. Google's mobile friendly test can help you identify any issues with your site's mobile friendliness. Link for the same is given in the description below. Next, number 5, Payday Loan Penalty. This algorithm targets sites that use spammy or manipulative tactics to rank for payday loans and other high interest queries. To fix this penalty, you need to remove any spammy content or manipulative tactics from your site. Next, number 6, Pigeon Penalty. It targets local search results and focuses on providing more accurate and relevant results for local queries. And to avoid a pigeon penalty, you need to ensure that your site is optimized for local searches, including use of local keywords and optimizing your Google My Business listing. Lastly, in order to fix any algorithmic penalty, you need to address the specific issue that caused the penalty, whether it's low quality content, spammy backlinks, or other issues. Once you have fixed the issue, it may take some time for Google to recrawl and re-evaluate your website. That's why you should keep monitoring your site's performance and make ongoing improvement to avoid any future penalties. In conclusion, I'd like to say that the best way to avoid Google SEO penalties is to follow its guidelines and best practices for SEO. And as Google has not released an exhaustive list of all the SEO penalties that it applies to websites, the penalties that I've mentioned in this video are some of the most common ones that are known and have been discussed widely in the SEO community across the globe. That being said, Google's algorithms and guidelines are constantly evolving, so new penalties may be introduced and existing penalties may be modified or updated, thereby making it important to keep up to date with Google's guidelines and best practices for SEO to avoid penalties and maintaining a strong online presence. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.